What up, guys? I'm back with another video. It's your boy Manny. So today I'm sitting here with Self-Made Dig. We're gonna get started on working on this lights, on the lights for Drac. We got a couple bars to remove. We got to do quite a few things to Drac. We got to do an inlay on some acrylic pieces on the actual lenses themselves. But we're going to get to actually cutting these pieces real quick. I got Self-Made Dig here with me. It's like 3,000 degrees outside, so we're going to just do them right here in the house. It's hot as hell outside. If I do it outside, it's going to, like I said in the last video, it'd be late at night. So let me try to prop up my phone here so I can bring y'all along on the way. Hold on 1 second. Let me prop my phone up and I'll bring y'all right back. All right. Hold it still. As y'all can see, we got the first two bars cut out. We definitely got to grind these down so that it's all smooth like this. So I didn't want to cut too close because I didn't want to get into the natural lines. So I just rather take my time and grind them down slowly. And then we got to weld them all in so that they smooth like that all the way around the light. So let me get these other two bars coming out. And me and Self-Made Dig, we'll be right back with y'all. I'll let y'all in a minute. Let me get these bars cut out. I got actually two lights to do. I'll hit y'all back in a minute. It's your boy Manny. I'm out. Thank you. Solid metal. I thought they was like thinner than that. Alright, bring it more close to the edge so I can grind this down. So now is where you really got to be careful because I don't want to mess up this line. So hold it still. All right, guys, so, man, it was hell cutting them lights. Whole bunch of little metal shavings hitting you in the face. See, I got my, not that I don't need my glasses, I made sure I wore them this time because metal shavings was flying. Self-made digs in the process of sweeping up. Those are all the metal shavings that we actually cut out of the light. And let me show y'all the light real quick. Let me show y'all the light, what we got here. So this is where we at so far with the lights. So everything is shaved down, as you can see right here. I still got to clean all the edges up, but for right now, we got them down. So we got to shave them up. Then I got to weld all the seams, sand them again, and get them ready to be powder coated. So yeah, that part. And we still got to take this light apart. I need to soak this light because this light is full of rust. And I don't want to break these ends off. So I'm going to soak all this with some PB Blaster. Take a wire brush and clean everything up. And these screws right here, these screws going to be a bitch getting out. So, yeah. Got my work cut out for me taking this light here apart. But yeah, ain't nothing I can't do. These are the actual new lenses, and I got to do a little fab work to these as well. So yeah, let me get busy, get to work, and I'll come back with y'all in a few minutes here. Let me get myself set up to start welding these lights in place. It's your boy Manny. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the channel Life with Manny, and we're gonna finish getting these lights together for Stunner, man. All right, I'm gonna holler at you. So we reached a point, we got the lights all welded up, and we got them smoothed out a little bit. It takes a couple hours for this stuff to dry, so we just got to really move on to the next light. But it's still wet. I'll just grab a light and kind of show y'all where we at. So this is the Hold on 1 second. So this is the actual light. And as you see, they all welded up. Just waiting on everything to dry. And then I gotta sand them down. And then after I sand them down, they may need to be hit again. I can't use any, pardon my phone for a second, but I can't use anything like Bondo or nothing like that, because when I'm being powder coating, gonna be heat. That stuff will heat up. So I gotta use a metal product like JB Weld, you know, to get them to actual turn into a hard substance that can withstand the heat. But yeah, I'm gonna soak this other one, get this other one done. I'm still working on self-made dig car. Me and him got some blocking down to do, so we can get ready to paint the car. So hopefully have it painted one day next week. I would love to do it tomorrow, but one day next week for sure we'll get it painted. And I just got a ton of things going on. But yeah, I'll let y'all in a minute when I get a little bit more progress on this or the next project. It's your boy Manny. I'm out. What up, gang? So today we're at the point where we're actually gonna sand these lights, the light bezels. So they're good and hard now. It took longer for the weld to set, longer than I wanted to. You can see it here. It said between 6 and 8 hours, but it actually took like a day. Day and a half for them to actually set. I had went to the monster truck show yesterday, so now we gonna get to sanding these lights. So let's get this process started. Let's get started. Just using the sanding stone, and I'm gonna see how this works. And if not, I'll get some. But this should work. You want to take your time with it. You want it to end up nice and smooth. Know how this sanding stone gonna work. Don't look like it's taking very much off. Doing what I wanted it to do. So I may have to go to a different technique or get a heavier grinding stone. I mean, it's taking it down, but it's just, this process is going to take me 3 days to get them nice and flush. Working though, I guess. Thank you.
working. It's gonna take a while. I'd rather go slow then. Have to repeat the process, so we just take our time and work with this stone.
It's getting kind of smooth. We'll see. Achieve what you're trying to achieve, and two, you could cause yourself to have to redo this all over again. I kind of want to take it down and slow it. I can't really dig in there so y'all can see it, so but yeah. It's working. We got a hot spot like right in there. But this is how it started. I don't know if y'all can really tell how lumpy it is all across there. So it's cutting it down very slowly. Got a little hot spot, like I say, right in here. See the shininess or low spot, whatever. And just trying to take my time with it, man. Edge here is kind of what we're looking for, a real smooth transition. And I could be using some less hard. The original plan was to powder coat these, but I think we might go with painting. So if we're gonna paint them, now that I got this on here, after I take it down, I can go with a real thin coat of fiberglass, then maybe a little bit of body fill over and get them always smooth. If we were powder coating them, I would only go with the metal filler here. because powder coating heats it up, and I would be afraid of what it does to the fiberglass or the Bondo or body filler or whatever. But with, if we paint them, I can really work them and get them A1. But either way it go, we're going to get them A1. So let me finish sanding here, and I'll come back with y'all on the finish. Let me get to working on these. Just matter of fact, let's keep it rolling.
The stories are truth and stories are sin.
OVO Sound Radio.
Yeah. The ball is in your court. No defense, nobody keep the score. No offense, but I've played this before. Maybe you cared and you just don't care anymore. Evolve. Yeah. And I'm right back here when I said I wouldn't. Right. You were never a good girl, but you're a better woman now. Evolve. 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 Look, you remind me of Jane Birkin. Your body insane in person. Wanna do special things for you, you deserve it. But you too famous to buy you purses. That barely scratches the surface. This time is different, you give me purpose. Tell me you taking it serious. I gotta ask how serious, cause yo serious, it's just been not that serious. Got me on tour acting like I'm not that curious. Ignoring all the pistols that's thrown at me. Been thinking about home actually, where Rox has Kim and Mark has Ashley and Neeks has Easy, and I don't even know what I have anymore. Evolve. Evolve. Evolve.
Back with some more progress on these lights for Cuzzo. Shout out to Stunner for giving me the opportunity to knock these lights out for Drac. Appreciate you, cuz. But let's take a look at the lights. So that's kind of where we are now. They got some imperfections that were already in there. Little stuff like that. We're going to try to knock some of them down. Pits there. Little chips and things. We're going to try to see if we can straighten some of this stuff out before he sends it off. Big chip there. Yeah, so we're gonna, we got him truing straight. We just gotta do a little bit of touch up right there. I'll sand that down a little bit. But it looked way better from where it came from. Yeah, those lines there are definitely ain't truing straight. Same, ooh-wee. Yeah, that's a mess. Yeah, but we're gonna make that. And that look just like this. Alright. Wait till y'all see the finished product. It's gonna be dope. Alright, let me finish up with this. Let me give me some brunch because I missed breakfast. And I'll holler back at y'all in a minute. It's your boy Manny. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the channel. I'm out. Yo, what's up, gang? It's your boy Manny. I'm back with another video. Today we are continuing sanding on Stunner's tail lights for Drac. Man, this has been a long process. The bolts were actually rusted in there, so I had to actually heat the bolts up to get them out. After I let them soak for a couple days, then I decided to go ahead and try some heat because soaking them with the penetrant was not working. Woke up this morning with a headache for some reason. I don't know what, but my head has been killing me all morning. And it's like noon, 1 o'clock. I just ate something. Now I'm going to get in here. Excuse me. Get in here and get to sanding on these lights. Still got a wet sand and block Diggs Prius down so we can get ready for paint. Like I said before, it's been a long time since I actually did body and fender. And by no means, not a body man, but I know enough that I can get it done. So that's going to be an exciting process. Not say it's going to be a $1 billion paint job, but I'll do my best. And that's all I can do. But yeah, man, let's getting ready next week to get up out of here. I got some things to take care of with Stunner, so we're going to be getting up out of here real soon. But other than that, let me, let's go ahead and check these lights out. Man, I hope everybody's having a good day.
A few moments later.
Show y'all what we have with these real quick. So this is the second light. And as y'all see, this light is heavily, this bezel is heavily pitted. And I had to do a lot more JB Weld on these things. The whole bottom and almost the whole top, because the pits in there, oh my God, are horrible. And they deep. It's just not like thin pits. Those pits are pretty deep. So with the pits being pretty deep, I gotta do a lot of work to this one. This one, as you see, not so much, a couple, and I only had a couple little spots to do. This one's ready for me to pretty much just go over it again and then prime them for them. Yeah, let me prop this camera up. Pardon my reach. Let me prop this camera up so I can, I know it's a better process to doing this than what I'm using, but I'm using what I got. I'm not trying to really spend a lot of money on this project. I bought these discs a while ago and had them, so. But anyway, enough talk, let's get to it. We'll be right back.
I gotta go charge my battery.
All right, let me charge my battery here, and I get back with y'all in a little bit once I get these sanded down before I go to the next step. It's your boy Manny. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the channel Life with Manny. Holla, y'all. Got a flat block in here. Got a bunch of different size blocks actually, but that's just overkill for this project. Got all different style blocks. That's for like the curves on a body panel. This one's for a bigger curve on a body panel. And this is a flat block for most of your doors and flat spots on the body. So I got plenty of blocks, but those are just way too big. So using a little short block. So everything stays nice and straight. Which this still is not going to get it 100%. But better than it being weighed. It's a long process. It's a real long process. Alright guys, so we actually at the point of wet sanding. So just wet sanding them smooth. Pretty much almost done with this one. Make sure I get in all these little, they got a bunch of different creases where you want the paint to stick, primer to stick, whatever. So just trying to pay attention to all these corners, all these edges, and getting it real clean. I'm using a little soapy water, and right now I'm using 600, I believe, just getting it smooth and ready for paint. I need to see where I'm at before I send them out, so I'm gonna shoot a coat of primer on them, and I think I got some thinner, shoot some primer on them. All the edges are pretty much there. The fronts are there. Yeah, it's actually looking good. I already went around all the edges and everything. And just looking over it. I don't know what y'all think, but it almost looked factory-like. Pretty much almost there. So we're gonna call this one quits and we're gonna get the other one. We're gonna let that one dry. Ready this other one. And here's a picture of the other one. So y'all can see all that gunk that I took off of this one. Let's do a side by side. Let me know what y'all think. This one look better or this one? Yeah, that part. All right. Let's get a little soapy water. Get to it. Yeah, all this stuff got to come off. And all this pitted area needs to get as smooth as possible. The primer only going to cover so much. So, you know, I'm probably going to have to do a little bit of body work. I know Stunner told me don't worry about the bottom, but I'm just picky like that, man. I want to make sure the whole light's straight.
I know nobody will ever see this area I'm standing right now. I get it. But guess what? If this area start peeling, it's going to show peeling to the face of it. How about that part? So you got to do the right things right. Yes, make sure the whole project is sealed up. And again, we don't got to worry about blocking down just the metal, because it's not going to get wavy or nothing. It really is just cleanup is what I'm doing right now. All in these edges where it's going to be a potential problem later on. Shit, that shit going to start peeling like a motherfucker. So nah, we don't want that. No, we want to make sure this shit right. Now up in this area, on this one, I got a little bit more work to do, but that first one's ready. Yeah, but this one ain't ready yet. I'm just really overstepping myself right now, because this one, this motherfucker ain't near ready. So we might just stop on this one for a minute. But this one really ain't ready to be at the step I'm at right now. I'm actually stepping ahead of myself with working on this second one. Yeah, we're gonna chill on this one. I don't wanna mess up nothing. So we're gonna come back to this one, because I still got some rough spots that I don't like. So I gotta still dremel some more on this one. They're both pretty much getting close. Alright, we're going to rinse this one off and let it dry. We're going to go to the garage and shoot a coat of primer on this first one and see what we got. Alright, let me get myself set up in the garage. Thank you.
So
that's the first layer of primer. I knew it would be little blemishes in it. So we still gotta sand it down again. And I put a little spot putty in certain places, but overall, I think it's a winner. It's got a few places I need to put a little bit of spot putty, but we look good. Alright, my battery's going dead on my pocket too here, so now that this is off, I can talk normal. So my battery's going dead. Let me let this dry. And I'll come back at y'all with the next step. I got to go back in the crib and work on the first one and get it together. So, all right, I'll holler at y'all in a minute. Man, gang, I know I'm looking like a wild man by the head, but y'all already know I'm still at it. So, without further ado, let me just take y'all on this journey with me. So, lower this camera a little bit. So we're in the process now of sanding them down, getting the lines right. So we got these lines. The lines have to be true and straight. So I had to go over them because I had hollered at cuz, and I guess he was like, at first, just like, you know, let the guy here finish him. But he asked me to go ahead and, you know, work on him a little bit more. You know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna knock them on out for him. Get these lines right. It's got like four lines that you gotta get. Oops, knock my camera over. Four lines that you gotta get true and straight. You know what I'm saying? So it's quite a bit of little tediousness, and you know, whatever you put on, you gotta take off. So I built all this up. Now I'm in the process of taking it down because, like right here, the line has left, but I gotta get it back. Yeah. Give me a second and I'll show y'all pretty much one that's the first one that's kind of done. Ready for prime. I'm gonna prime them up tonight so I can give them to them tomorrow. Alright, let me show y'all this one real quick. You can see it. It's the one that's done. Ready for prime. All the edges nice and straight. Those are the edges I'm talking about. So, yeah, we got had to get all those right. Yeah, so let's let's finish getting these lines straight. It's hard keeping a little piece of sandpaper. On these lines. And it's time consuming to say the least. Knocking all these edges down. Got a half spot here. That's why you see me sticking in this one spot. There's a half spot, a couple of them over in this area. When I filled it back in, I didn't clean up behind myself. You pay for it, not cleaning up behind yourself. all this stuff, just sitting here sanding for some extra time. You gotta just be careful that you don't take off what you built up. Be repeating this shit for hours. I be trying with my left hand, man. My left hand coordination ain't the same as my right. So now it's time to get to it. Let's get the spraying. So use a little air. Already wiped it down with a tack cloth and alcohol. Now it's time to get busy. Serve, looking like money. All right, that's the first coat. I'm only gonna hit it twice. Let's take an inspection. Yes, sir, we looking good. All right, I'm gonna move this one out the way. Careful not to bump anything, so we can go ahead and go over the second one. All right, got that one out the way. Let's get the second one sprayed. I'm gonna spread like this. All right, there we go. Let's plug the gun back up. Hit it with the air. Let's get it. Hit it with the air. I was a little heavy on this one. Always control your hose. You don't want your hose bumping at it. Yes, sir. Looking good. prime it heavy so it can be wet sanded down. So that the guy that he got painting them, like I said, I could have painted them, but I just had to go buy some black. I don't have any black. Only got paint for the project that I'm working on. All right. Like I said, I like to prime heavy. Let's take a look, gang. We got here, gang. Yes, sir. Paint by Manny. See, y'all didn't know your boy got down like this, huh? I know. Ooh-wee. Yes, sirski. I can really stop there, but I'm going to prime it heavy. Let's take a look at this one. Yes, sirski. Those are, like I told Stunner, a couple pits that was in it. I've been working them for a couple days now. They're not going to be 100%, but 99% I'll take. All right, Cuzzo, this one for you, my boy. Priming it a little bit heavy so he has something to work with. There we go. Hit it with a little air. I'm going heavy so I don't get no runs. That's just air. There you go, my boy. Is this what you was looking for? Clean my camera. Hold on. Prop my gun up. I want my fucking gun to fall. Hold on. Clean my camera. Is that what you was looking for, my boy? Yes, sir.
Several hours later.
What up, gang? So, man, just got up, had to come out and meet Cuzzo, man. He got the pieces back from the painter. So yeah, how'd the pieces come out, cuz? Alright. We're gonna get a first look at the light vessels and see how they came out. Now I gotta get busy and put the lights in and everything and so we can put these in. Yes, sir. Hey man, you picked them. Did you pick them up for Dodge for Chevy? It looked like those came from Dodge, bro.
I know, right?
Ooh wee. What you think? Okay. Don't drop it, bro. Whatever.
Think about them, cuz.
I love them.
These mugs came out nice. people won't even know that it used to be them bars.
It's just gonna watch your fingers on the front. Don't try not to touch the front of them.
It's just gonna look real clean.
Tuck that towel. Tuck that towel under there. And then I'll put them up when I get to the house. Move that bag. Take that bag and stuff. Put it on the seat, please. I don't want nothing to hit it, bro. Just picking up some paint supplies today so we can get him finished up.
Yeah. You excited, then?
For sure.
Then did you show him them color swatches?
Which one? From Danny? No, I didn't show him yet. Okay. I didn't show him yet. Yeah.
He don't like that.
I don't know. He's saying he don't want to do it. So. I talked to him about it, but I didn't show him to him because he was just like, I don't know if I want to do it and da 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 whatever. He's just being lazy. So I'm gonna have to just get it and do it.
I'm being lazy if I want
you. The door panels.
What door? Oh. No.
Oh. Oh.
No.
I don't know if I want to do all that.
No.
I don't really got time for all that.
He wanted to add the blue in there, but I told him let's do the whole interior if we're gonna do it.
No, just the accents.
Yeah, but you're gonna have blue.
What
gray,
you think, cousin?
I think it's gonna, like, that's like you and your band just throwing some blue panels with it. It's gonna,
I see both ways, but don't they got seat covers that wrap it?
No.
Or they don't?
I had to get something made.
Oh, okay, got it.
That's what I'm saying.
I thought they had pre-made.
And I don't want wrap it blue. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna do how the CAs, they got like the navy blue and the wrap it. You know, they got the two-tone blue.
Okay.
I'm gonna do something like that.
So that ain't what we talking about anyway.
Want to add blue to the door panels, but it's gonna look odd because the seats gonna be black and then the console, everything else gonna be great. I feel like it's gonna just be too much in there until we ready to do the whole thing, and then we could go crazy. I don't care. You
anything better than the dirty ass fake suede?
I do black for right now.
You do black.
Right, hey, now. Man, if they was pink, it's better than the tri-color door panels that you got. Oil stains. Ain't no other type of parking lot stains you got on them doors, bro.
Bro, what?
Yo, midnight boogie stains on the doors.
Pause,
bro.
No diddy. Take the baby with me. Hey, but anyway, we'll figure out the color for his door panels. Probably gonna go with this rapid that me and Cuzzo found. That's a dope ass color.
Maybe.
You never know.
When you leaving? In the morning?
Yeah.